All right, let's get this party started. Hey, once again, my name is Marcel and welcome to One Home Lab. In this video series, we will explore how Matter devices can expand KNX and Loxone smart homes. So we'll try to get as many different Matter devices from different manufacturers, get them into One Home server, and then see how they perform and how we can use them alongside our existing smart home system. So use this series as inspiration to give you some ideas what you can do with One Home server, with Matter devices, and with your KNX or Loxone smart home. Now, just to be clear, in this series, we won't be going too deep into each Matter device. So this means no in-depth review, also no in-depth setup guide. We will also not give out any scoring or recommendations. We are just interested how we can use these Matter devices in one home. Okay, now that this is clear, let me introduce you to our little testing facility. We have found a small corner in our office to set up this permanent studio, and we hope to record many videos from here. So for our KNX setup, it's quite simple. We have our One Home server, we have an MDT switching actuator, and then we have a MDT push button. And this light bulb is connected to the MDT switch actuator, which means that, of course, when the switch turns on, we can see a visual here with this light. So of course, to not delay anymore, let's just go straight into it. For the first episode, we decided to go with IKEA Matter devices. Now we all know that IKEA has been in the smart home game for quite a long time, but on 11th September this year, IKEA announced that their new hub, the Rigera hub, will support Matter, which means that all IKEA devices going through this hub can be controlled via Matter and can be also brought to One Home server. So let's just go a little bit through what we have prepared for today. Now, please don't be angry for me butchering all these names, but IKEA is quite creative when it comes to naming their products. First of all, we need a hub. So this is their Dirigera hub that supports Matter. Then we have an inspelning smart plug. Then we have a Valhorn motion and presence detection sensor. Then we have a steerbar push button. We have a parasol contact sensor for windows, for doors. Then we have a Windstyrka air quality monitor. Then we have a Sombrig shortcut button. Of course, a thread-free RGB LED light. And at the end, we have a bad drink leak detection sensor. For now, Matter does not support it, but when it will, we will definitely be testing this one out too. Now, the setup of these devices is pretty straightforward. Since they are built on the Zigbee protocol, you still have to set them up via their IKEA Smart Home app. And when you bring all these devices into the Rigera hub, then you can bring them into One Home via Matter controller. And as we see, we already have them in our One Home dashboard. So now let's have some fun with it. First of all, let's make a simple automation where our KNX push button turns on the IKEA LED bulb. I have the LED bulb here behind me. I will hold it up for you to see. And when I press the push button, the lights turns off and turns on. And I can toggle it and it works near instantly. And now let's see how the automation is set up. It's pretty simple. In One Home automations, we set up a trigger that listens for the initial press on our KNX push button. Then we add an action that toggles the IKEA light. We save it, we run it, and as you see before, it works like a charm. For our next example, we can do it the other way. Let's turn on a KNX light with an IKEA push button. So we're using this shortcut push button called Sombrig. It has two buttons, but for this use case, we'll just use the top one. This is how the automation looks. We have a trigger, which listens for the initial press on the IKEA push button. And then for the action, we're toggling the KNX light. So how this all looks in action? When I press the button, the KNX light turns on. When I press it again, the KNX light turns off. Just as simple as that. Next, let's automate our smart plugs with our KNX push button. So I have two of these smart plugs and I have my video lights connected to them. The video lights are not smart. They're just plugged in the smart plug and they're set to a predetermined value for the correct exposure. And now I want to make it convenient for me to turn both of these lights on or off at the same time. And I want to do this with my KNX push button. Here's the automation for this. We first have a trigger for turning on these lights. And for this, we're listening for the initial press on the lower right side of the KNX push button. For the action, of course, we're then setting our smart plugs to be turned on, both of them at the same time. For turning off, I use a separate button on the left side of the push button. And of course, the action then involves turning off these smart plugs both at the same time. So let's check it in action. I click the button and the lights turn off. And of course, now you don't see me, but if I click the bright button for turning on the lights turn on again. Quite convenient for me for recording these videos. But now, of course, let's say that when I turn off these lights, I'm of course stuck in the dark. I can't do anything because I don't see anything. So I want my KNX light to turn on when my video lights turn off. And I want to do this with the IKEA brightness sensor. Let's check out the automation for that. We have a trigger that listens for brightness changes on our IKEA Valhorn brightness sensor. Then we set a condition. If the brightness value is below 10 lux or equal to 10 lux, then we trigger the action and the action turns on our KNX light. So let's see this in action. I will turn off my video lights. The brightness sensor will trigger the automation. And if it will be dark enough, the KNX light will go on. There we go. Now I can see my way out of the office. All right, let's keep going. Let's say you want to automate your porch light or like a light on your balcony. You just use this contact sensor from IKEA. It's very slim, self-adhesive. You put it on any door and window. And then you can use automations to automate your outside light. So when the contact opens, the door opens, the light turns on. When it closes, the light turns off. Let's see this in automations. So the automation is really simple. You have a trigger that listens to changes on our contact sensor. So when the contact sensor opens, we trigger this automation. And for the action, it's really simple. We just set our on-off value to inherit the value of our sensor. And here it is in action. I open the sensor, light turns on. Close the sensor, light turns off. And you can go even further than that. If you have an outside brightness sensor, you can simply add a condition. We can use the brightness sensor, pull in the value. We set less than or equal, so the lux value. And let's say in the evening, let's say if it's below 100 lux, the automation will run. And if not, it won't. So you won't have your KNX light turning on in broad daylight. Next, let's use this Windstyrka air quality monitor and temperature and humidity sensor to control our KNX system. So let's say that you have temperature sensors maybe in your push buttons. Of course, those are fixed on the wall. But what if you want to measure your temperature in the middle of the room? That would require quite some remodeling if you go the KNX way. So we have brought this Windstyrka to one home via Matter. And now we want to send humidity data and temperature data to our KNX system. For the trigger, we're listening for humidity changes in our air quality monitor. and the second trigger is for temperature changes. And then for the action, we simply write to KNX group address and we send the value of humidity or temperature. This way we can control our KNX HVAC with a Matter sensor. So this is it, the first episode of One Home Lab. I really hope you enjoyed. I hope you got some inspiration on what you can do in your own KNX home. And of course, this is just the first episode of this series. We are open for feedback. We would like to hear from you. What are your wishes? What do you want to see in this One Home Lab? If you have wishes to see some specific Matter devices or devices from specific manufacturers, please let us know and we'll try to get as many as possible, test them out and show them to you. If you have any more questions, always feel free to comment down below. We read all the comments, we try to reply as soon as possible. And yeah, that's it. Until next time for the next episode of One Home Lab.